Poor, is that a brontosaurus or a...
No, that's another thing that annoys me. Diplodocus. No, it's a diplodocus. It's not a diplodocus.
It's a diplodocus.
No, it's not. It's a diplodocus.
It's not.
No, it's a diplodocus.
I've got a book that comes straight from the Natural History Museum and it does the phonetic saying.
I don't care.
It's diplodocus.
No, if you're a kid, it's a diplodocus.
I've said diplodocus my entire life until I got that book for Ted and now it's diplodocus.
Don't change that. Don't be forced to change
it. But it is. It's like tomato, tomato.
I've just realised he's not in shot anyway. Today, serious face. Today, it's health and safety, dad chat style. So, just checking we haven't got anything that's going to, like, that is... That's not good, is it, to have around?
That is not
good. That's your first tip.
Yeah. Don't leave kitchen knives around.
From last week's show when you did some unboxing. I'll put that in a safe. Always hand a knife.
Very nice. Yeah. I hate health and safety.
You got to have health and safety.
You do, but I hate... That's not true. I hate it in a professional setting.
Yeah, but again, that's just businesses covering their back. You know, the dad chat lawyer, you know, if we had one, who happens to be Ted.
Yeah, he'd probably have a lot to say about the set.
Fortunately, Ted's age 3, so he doesn't know much about health and safety.
No.
So that's why we employed him.
And he has no concept of risk.
No, absolutely not.
He's like, yeah, I'll jump off there. What? Don't, please.
But that's why you need health and safety when it comes to children. Health and safety around the house is... As kids start off, when they're babies and they don't do much apart from poo and sick and eat, then that's good. Health and safety is not a problem, and you never really think that your child's going to get older or bigger, even though you know they are. Does that make any sense?
Yes. Well, you're in that phase. You're in the phase,
and then you get surprised when they are taller and can grab stuff. You go, hang on a second, when could this happen? Well, it's going to happen.
Yeah.
So have you baby-proofed pretty much everything? Did you? So
we did a certain level of baby-proofing, probably not as much as Jen would have wanted us to.
Yeah, but then it's fair to say my wife Charlie was exactly the same.
They panic about everything. I mean, if it was up to her, we wouldn't have a kitchen.
No, you would be living in a foam house.
Yes.
Wouldn't you? Everything covered in bubble wrap
exactly.
Or foam.
Exactly.
No, I get that. So the little corner things on the tables, did you do all that?
Yeah, so you get these little rubber bits, whack them on the corners of your coffee table, or we've got a fire. It's not an actual real fire, it's actually electric.
Yeah.
And it looks pretty rubbish.
Devastated. Yeah.
But on the corners, it's quite sharp, so we put some corner things on there.
But then there's another frustration for you, because, you know, your partners want you to make sure everything is baby proof, then you go on Amazon, you buy the little corner table things, they're like black foam or whatever, they're like, well, they look disgusting, can you not get something which looks better? No!
Yeah.
There's not much of a selection! Yeah.
How about a nice wood table? That would look better.
But I do get that covering the corners, doing all that, you know, making sure you minimise risk, I do get all that as well. I try to think what else we've done.
Also, we did... This is funny. Jen went on and on and on at me to try to get those latches that stop the cupboard doors opening.
So
eventually I went down to B&Q and I bought some, came home, fitted them like immediately, which is rare for me. Usually I'll get it and then a couple of weeks later I'll fit it. Anyway, did it straight away. Ted walked up to it. Did it? It wouldn't open, so he just went and opened it straight
what,
away.
Literally the power, he just
came out, just ripped it straight open. I was like, what waste of time that was.
And there's different versions. So have you seen those ones which are like, you attach one on one side and it clicks in, and then you attach the other thing on the other side and it clicks in. So it's like a little plastic thing.
Yeah,
it's like take a latch. It off, and then you can, like, they're a faff. Then there's the ones where they have a little lock, so you hit the drawer and you have to press down for that one to come out. Is that making sense?
Yeah.
There isn't one they've made yet.
No. Which,
have you seen the one with a magnet?
No.
Oh my God.
Strong is that magnet?
Well, we've got one on our TV cabinet because that's like a haven for toddlers. They see lights flashing, Wi-Fi.
Yeah, remotes.
Blue LED remotes, you know, Skybox, DVD player. It's like a heaven for those. So what you have to do is you attach these things, and then to open it, you have to get a magnet. It's a little round magnet. You put that on the front of the cabinet. It finds the magnetic, clicks the switch off.
But then it's gadgety.
But when he finds the magnet, though, he's having a whale of a time. It's like a little toddler in a safe.
Where is it? There's something a bit concerning about a magnet near a monitor, TV screen.
Oh, I don't know, Al. Now, I've actually done some stuff on this on our JK and Charlie channel. We did a video based on the Groegg. Now, again, genuinely one of my favourite things with this whole baby thing going on. When Noah came into our lives, I am absolutely paranoid about temperature. Because it's the one thing that kids can't regulate their own temperature. So they don't know if they're hot or cold. So knowing what sort of temperature, the room is at, just for me, it's essential.
Yeah.
It's the one thing I panic the most about. And Charlie will always say that.
Exactly. Do you have the Groegg 1 or the Groegg 2?
We had the Groegg 1. In fact, one of our friends gave us that after they had children, which was great. So we didn't pay for that. And then we got the Groegg 2.
So this is pretty good. We're going to have a quick look at it really quickly.
Best bit.
I know.
It's squidgy.
Yeah.
If you ever get stressed, just get your Groegg and do that.
Yeah. But it also means it's very durable for the kids. So if Ted wants to grab that or drop it, it's fine. Because, you know, they've made that really squidgy.
USB. Yes!
Genius.
I just love USB.
I know.
I think it's one of my favourite things in the world. It's so easy. You can get plugs which have got like various, like 3 or 4 USB bits. Just, I love USB. We got some of our dads to check this out as well, didn't we?
We did, yeah. So we took the Groegg 2 to a recent Dad Network live event in central London. 80 dads gathered and we showed them the Groegg and this is what they said about it.
Oh yeah, waking up in the middle of the night is always a bit difficult, especially when you've got a newborn. Our son especially woke up quite a lot because of needing a dummy, but as parents you worry about everything, don't you? And one of the things was temperature.
It's always a concern, you know, you've got to make sure that they're right, they're okay, they're not too hot, they're, you know, not hungry, they don't need a nappy change.
So before this we were using another kind of room temperature thing, which was a black digital display, which for me didn't work as well because in the middle of the night, you're waking up, eyes all bleary, you go into the room trying to work out what the temperature is, and it takes a little while to kind of register what's going on.
You open the door, you don't have to go in to look at the temperature, you can just tell by the colour. The Groegg is fantastic. Quite a lot of the monitors actually look at the temperature where the camera is, not where the baby is. So what we found with this is that you could put this very close to the cot, it's very squashy, so if he grabs it, he's not going to damage himself.
What's best, I think, about the Groegg is that it gives you a visual representation of what the temperature is in the room. And that's always really handy because previously we've just had the temperature on the baby monitor and it's not so easy to see at night time.
First I was a bit sceptical, thinking, does it really matter that much? And then you read all about babies getting too hot, too cold, they can't regulate the temperature like adults can. So I felt like this was a great idea and been using it ever since, really.
You don't have to look too closely, you can just see straight away from a distance. That's perfect temperature.
So having a Groegg would have been really useful when my little nephew used to stay over, because he always used to get febrile convulsions when he got too hot, and it was really difficult to know what to dress him in or whether to have the window open or keep the door open. But if we'd had a Groegg back then, it would have been great, so we could have regulated his temperature a bit better.
So there you go. Seems like it's gone down very well with the dads. Thank you very much to the Groegg Company for sponsoring the Dad Network Live and sharing the Groegg 2 with us.
So that's what the dads thought about the Groegg 2. We've actually done a video, me and my wife, Charlie, so if you want to go and see that, we'll put a link below in the comments. I think that's the health and safety over and done with now from a dad's point of view, isn't it?
It is. I'm all health and safety out for a week. That's it, me done.
Now we're going to fill in forms.
Some red tape to jump on.
See you next week.